was here at the Bio 360 conference to educate people on biochar. Biochar is a word not many people have heard of, but it's actually an ancient technology developed in many indigenous cultures around the world. And it can actually help deal with organic matter, which is excess from the production of crops. You can use residues from bioenergy production. It's basically taking biomass that is baked in an oxygen-limited environment and turning it into a charcoal-like substance. The difference between charcoal and biochar is that we don't use it for cooking or heat.
So biochar is just one term that describes a wide range of different products. It's not a silver bullet, it's not a pill that is going to cure all sicknesses. Rather, it's a very diverse product that can be part of an integrated climate combat strategy.
And we see a growing demand in the biogas sector for our technology with pyrolysis because of the more restricted regulations regarding land application of biosolids. This could be due to micropollutants and also microplastic. Pyrolysis will take the biosolids and create valuable products such as biochar and syngas and also a condensate. These products can be beneficially used at the biogas plant to boost your biogas production, or you can produce energy, heat, steam or electricity to either be used at the plant or be exported.
So there's one commercial demonstration plant operating outside Mount Gambier in South Australia, which people can book and come and see. It makes about a megawatt of syngas, which currently we burn in a boiler, in a hot water boiler, to make hot water for the glasshouse. It also makes about a quarter of a tonne an hour of biochar, which is used to pay for the wood, basically. So the recycling company that supplies the wood in moving floor trailers take away the biochar as payment for that service. So essentially the glasshouse is getting their energy for free. In doing so, the overall process is very carbon negative because the syngas displaces fossil fuel that would have been used previously, and the biochar locks up atmospheric carbon dioxide that was in the biomass. So the overall process is carbon negative by about 0.75 tonne an hour of CO2 equivalent.
We produce quite a unique wood power plant that is also a kind of a tree generation plant. So our main product is electricity. So we turn wood chips mainly into electricity, but also into heat and biochar. And that makes us quite unique because normally you have to sort out between heat, power or biochar, and we deliver all three of them. We are an Austrian-based company in our 10th anniversary. We have now built almost 16 power plants, so I'm very, very optimistic. We have a very high-grade byproduct on the start, the biochar, which gives our plants a negative emission footprint at the moment, right now. So we, at certain stages, we can claim we have the first negative emission technology commercially running. Yeah, I'm very optimistic. Still, the market is not really there, so the projects are very picky, and you have to have innovative customers that find a niche to make it profitable. We'll be right back.